So, how is it going, guys and girls? It's Oakley here, and today I'm in Finley's room. The reason for which is that he's decided to take up decimating my bedroom, playing a mixture of like FIFA and GTA. He's actually been teaching me a few things on FIFA. You'll be very, very happy to hear, I'm sure, because all of you will know. I'm getting too relaxed. I'm so god that you can see in my eyes how tired I am. I've been in the most bizarre mood today. A feeling that it's like getting carried over from the weekend. But by the way, the vlog that I did last night about the Russian drug mafia bust thing apparently was not true. There was the story behind it was completely true. However, it turns out it wasn't a drugs bust. It was actually like an armed robbery. A robbery? Oh, you can see exactly what I mean now. An armed robbery was in progress or had been in progress, and they believed that they traced them back to the house. And apparently, the police like rammed the door and stuff, but they were out there for 15 hours to defuse the situation. So it was, like as I said, a very, very long time frame. I'm not really feeling this. I want to get back up on my feet. I feel like I'm going to fall asleep if I stay there for too much longer. There we go. Go back into this room. This has just been, I've just discovered. Hugh, what are you doing? What are you doing just lying there? You're just tweeting. Just what? Preying? What does that mean? Okay. If you pre something, that's not looking, mate. Creeping. You're creeping. Huey, that's what you do at a school disco. This is how you creep at a school disco. You get up on one foot on the wall, lean your back like this, and then you just creep. You put some sunglasses on, and you just creep. Do a video, Mum. Yeah. By the way, what's going on with the severe lack of effort of hiding the Christmas presents?
Can you not go in there?
Well, I'm in here now, so I'll leave. I wasn't looking. I walked in. I said, what the heck? Why is there no, like, secrecy, cloak and dagger stuff going on? What happened to those days? Okay. I'm being grown. I'm going back downstairs now. I'm now in my bedroom again. Hello, Finley.
Hello.
Do you want to say hello?
What, are you still recording?
Yes, I'm recording. I'm going to just sit on my bed. I can't go in. I'm a prisoner in my own home. This is what's happening. This is the crap. Can I just put my feet here, Finn? Thanks. What are you laughing at?
They're laughing at you.
Who are laughing at me?
Everyone in the party.
Who's in the party?
Oh, what?
And why did you...
They heard you kill me.
I don't even know what I was talking about. I've been kicked out of two rooms. What? It's not even funny. Very tired. Watched two films last night. I watched one about Will Ferrell where he was, like, his life was being written by a woman who's writing a book. I think, I can't remember what it's called. His name was, like, Harold Creek or Harold something. Then watched Waterboy, which is a very funny film. Got back home. And I saw on Twitter, just before I was about to go to bed, that Toby Jizzle, Zerka, JJ, I think it's, I can't remember who else it was, tweeted saying Paul Walker had died. And originally I thought it was a hoax. As the link, I don't know, I think it was a sense of irony in the death, the tragedy, in the sense that he died in a car accident. I don't know, I just thought it was not real. What's wrong? I'm talking to the camera, mate. Okay. So I woke up this morning. So it wasn't a joke. And I don't know. It's bizarre for me because normally I don't really care too much. Like, it's not that I don't care. That sounds horrible, but it doesn't really affect me when like a celebrity dies. For example, when Michael Jackson died, you know, it's sad. Obviously, every death is sad. Every loss of human life is sad. But well, not every loss. If there's someone that's a very, very sick human being, and they're going to hell, then it's a positive thing. But it was just, I don't know, really, really, for some reason it hit me harder. I don't know the bloke, you know, I've never met him before in my life, but I still found it very, very upsetting. As it was weird for me because that was Fast and Furious, the first Fast and Furious was the first 15 that I watched when I was underage. I think I watched that film when I was 9 or 10 years old. And I still remember the house I watched it in, and I remember having to ask my mum's permission to watch it. Like, that's the sort of kid I was. And it had a massive impact on me, so I don't know. Very, very upsetting. Obviously, like, rest in peace to the poor man. And it, I don't know, but also at the same time, I think for somebody like him, it seems like quite a fitting way to go. Do you know what I mean? It's like certain people in life that you just can't see growing old. Well, at least that's my perspective, of course. But it's very, very sad. Very, very sad indeed. So yeah, that put me in a bizarre mood. And also something else that's disgusting, absolutely disgusting. I heard recently that there was a 21-year-old, so he's slightly young, it's about my age, recently was taken from town by two men when he was slightly drunk. And he was forced to take money out and then made to perform like sexual acts, which you guys know exactly what that means. And I thought that was just sickened me. It sickened me to death. It was just, and it was something in Watford, for Christ. There's not many places in Watford that can happen, because the way they described it, it's pretty much two places that can be. And I felt so sorry for this poor bloke who'd just been put through this terrible ordeal. And it was just like, what kind of sick bastards are there? I've been in one of these moods today where I'm questioning the fibre of like human beings. Like, you've got it. It's just sick. And I know it's sick, obviously, when the same thing happens to a woman. Of course it is. But I just physically, I couldn't get my head around it. It was absolutely disgusting. Absolutely. And also, it's not just that. It's more the fact that poor bloke is going to have that. It's going to have this fear in, like, for the rest of his life. And it is truly just disturbing. It really is disturbing. It's just been a fucked up day. It's like that, and then you add on the freaking helicopter. Just recently, there's just like so much horrible stuff going on in the world. It's just, ugh, absolutely horrible. But yeah, that's pretty much it from me today, guys. Also, one more thing I wanted to, I think I've already said this actually, so I'm not gonna go back into that. It's cool. But yeah, tomorrow I'm gonna have some FIFA out for you guys. As I said, me and Finley have been playing quite a lot there. I'm doing the outro, please. Just give me one moment, okay? Then you can tell me about your story. Okay. So yeah, I've got some FIFA out for you guys tomorrow, but just thought I'd give you guys a little vlog for no real reason, to be honest. I don't know. As I said, I'm in a very bizarre mood. Got like a mixture of tiredness, rage, and like upset at the same time. I feel like that poor bloke in Watford, 21, like that's his life, like. Absolutely disgusting. I hope that those two men rot in the depths of hell. It's a disgusting thing. But on that, I don't want to bring the mood down. The mood never really went up in this video. Maybe for the first 3 minutes it went up. But yeah, I'll speak to you guys soon. Hopefully you've enjoyed this. Drop a like, and also if you've got any thoughts on any of the stuff I've said in this video, be sure to leave them in the comment section down below. I've been Oakley, you've been fantastic. Have a great day and goodbye.